going on, guys? It's your boy Moose coming at you with another video. This video is another leather jacket review because your boy's still looking for one. So now the brand that we're going to be reviewing today is Straight to Hell. They're a really cool leather jacket brand based out of the US, and they don't only just make leather jackets. They also make shirts, they make jeans, they have women's clothing as well, women's leather jackets, normal jackets, coat. They have like a wide variety of stuff, accessories. And so they have some nice stuff on there. Like, I like their shirts a lot, just like the designs that they have. I haven't bought any. The designs look really, really cool. And so their main jacket is the Commando jacket. That's their staple. It's like your normal leather jacket with a belt. It has a very grunge aesthetic to it. The one I got was the Commando lightweight. The reason I got that is because I'm not looking for a heavy jacket. And so the price for this one, for all of them, range around $350. This one was $355. But I got it 25% off sale, and they have that sale still going on right now. So if you decide to get a jacket after watching this review, like, you might as well just do it now, because they 25% is like a pretty good deal. And again, yeah, I'm not looking for a heavy jacket. I'm looking for something light that I can just layer on. And so the first thing I want to talk about is the presentation of this jacket. I mean, I was just blown away. Like, it's these little details that make me want to shop from a brand. Like, it came in such like a nice case that has like the size of the jacket on it. It has the name of the jacket and the whole brand. It also came with a custom hanger, which is amazing. And it says Straight to Hell on it. And I love hangers, like I do. I don't have that many good hangers. So whenever I see like a wooden hanger come with my, you know, apparel that I buy, like, I'm more inclined to like shop from there again. Now, like, the overall presentation is great. It kind of reminds me of like Bodeskins in a way. I respect Bodeskins for the presentation. It's very nice when you order something from there. Like, it feels like it's very tailored towards you. Like, you even get a letter from the CEO. I feel like I got that similar vibe from Straight to Hell. Like, I feel like they really care about the customer. And so now let's talk about the quality of the jacket, which is really important, obviously. And in one word, guys, really, really good. It's, if you're looking for a sturdy leather jacket, the leather they use is actually full grain Buffalo Napa leather. Now, even though I got the lightweight jacket, it's still pretty thick and heavy, which I dislike personally. Like, for my, I was really surprised. Compared to my last jacket I reviewed from Deadwood, this is way heavier than that. Like, it is, this is a beast. And it's still called the lightweight jacket, which means it's not as heavy as their normal command. If you want a sturdy leather jacket, like, this is gonna be perfect. Like, this, you can have this for the rest of your life. The sleeves are pretty bulky, which kind of really turned me off, especially like the lower sleeves, like by the zips. They have that very bulky feel to it. I also noticed in all their pictures of the models wearing the jackets, they all wear the jacket with the zips open, which I found weird, like completely open. I don't know anyone that really does that. I personally, for my style, I don't like that. Like, I like them like halfway open, or maybe all the way zipped up even. The inside pocket of the jacket's actually really dope. It's like a zip pocket, and it also has like a beer opener, like a church key, that's what it's supposed to be called. You can also remove it though if you don't want it, you know? So like, it's a good option. The zippers, man, YKK zippers. Thank you, Straight to Hell, for putting on good zippers. Like, I don't know why every company doesn't just use really good zippers. You know, it irritates me when I see bad zippers. Like, it's not like my end all be all for bad zippers, but like, it's such a crucial part of the jacket, especially leather jackets. Like, you should have good zippers. So they have great zippers. That's a big plus. The belt is also removable. Oh my God, why doesn't every other company do this? The belt is removable. I rarely find jackets where the belt is removable. It's like ingrained into the jacket. And like, that's kind of a turnoff for me, because there's days where I'd want to have the belt on, and days where I don't want the belt on, you know? You could honestly buy this and wear this for the rest of your life, as I mentioned earlier. All the reviews I've seen on Reddit for this jacket are phenomenal as well. People love the jacket. Now, the last thing we didn't talk about yet is fit. Like, that's really crucial. So let's talk about fit. They made it really easy to find your size for this jacket. Like, if you go on their size chart, it has the measurements for the jacket as well as the measurements for your chest based on if you want like a regular fit or like a slim fit. For example, the 34S, I'm like a 33 inch chest, and this jacket is a 36 inch chest. So that means it's gonna be kind of like a relaxed, not perfectly slim fit, but like a relaxed, close to a regular fit. The sleeves are 23 inches for mine, and the length is also 23 inches. The length was fine, the sleeve length was also fine as well. On the chest, yeah, there's a bit room, but honestly, I like the fit of this more in general based on the chest than the Deadwood size medium I got in women's. But the real question is, am I keeping this jacket or not? That's like the main thing, right? And I'm actually not keeping the jacket, y'all. I am not, I'm returning it. And here is why. As I mentioned earlier, guys, the jacket is pretty bulky and heavy, as it should be. You know, it's full grain leather, Buffalo leather. But me personally, I prefer lighter leathers, like lambskin, for example, because I don't want to buy a jacket for the motorcycle purposes or something where it's super heavy. I just want something to layer with for fashion purposes. So that's why I'm returning this. I was kind of surprised that even though it's considered a lightweight Commando, that it was pretty heavy. One reason I'm returning, another reason, which is honestly the biggest issue for me, is the width of the sleeves. The length was fine, but the width just was too wide for my taste. I like a very slim, sleek YSL look, and these were just too wide, especially when I have them all zipped up. It looks like they're just bunching up. But if you look at the video right now and see how it looks like the sleeves bunching up, it's just not a good look. That being the biggest reason I'm gonna return this jacket. In terms of comfort, it's comfortable and it's like fine to wear. It's just the two problems are it's bulky and the sleeves are just too wide. And the sleeves again is the main crucial part which turned me off. If the sleeves were slimmer, I'm not even kidding, I probably would have kept this jacket and I would have been done on my hunt for a leather jacket. Like this would have been it. But unfortunately, that's not the case. Also, ideally, if you want a good example of how I'd want my leather jacket to fit, just look at how this H&M suede jacket fits me. It fits me so good. I love how it feels. It's very lightweight, and obviously it's not real suede, so that's another reason why it's lightweight. But I tried on, like the Deadwood leather jacket that I tried on my last review, that was pretty light, and I love the feel of that. Now again, we don't know what leather they use, so I'm assuming it's something light, something maybe like lambskin or something. So my options now, I'm highly considering maybe in the fall is getting that Deadwood leather jacket in a size small again. Because out of all these jackets that I've tried so far, I felt the most confident in that size small. Yes, it was a bit tight on the shoulders. Yes, it kind of bunched up on the back. I think it would just stretch out over time, honestly. I think it'll fit me better. And I just felt the best wearing that. Like, it just fit me tight, but like, it also fit me good. It's like hard to explain. And these ones just fit me big, and I don't like the look of that at all. That's probably what I'm gonna do. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and it's really helpful for you guys. If you're looking to possibly buy this jacket, I'd buy it soon and ASAP. If you have any other questions about fashion or even this jacket or anything in general, you can DM me guys. You can leave a comment down on this video, whatever. And if you guys decide to buy this jacket, please, I want to know how you like it, how it feels. Like, just DM me and let me know. With that being said, I hope you guys enjoy this video and I'll see you guys when I see you guys. Take it easy, everybody. 24 hours.